your testimony. Brethren, I have encountered God to a point that when men gang up against people like us, and heaven arose, say, this one, you cannot touch it. I had an encounter once. Without my knowledge, you know, I used to work in those days with Chemical and Allied Product PLC, CAPL. I was their corporate engineering manager before I retired. I didn't retire, I resigned. When I was coming to camp, I just resigned. You know, it's so funny to me, I don't work in a place more than 5 years. And in the other 5 years, I was tired and I resigned. And before I ever resigned, something happened. One day, I was just walking at the corridor. But honestly, brethren, I was a psychedelic engineer. I was not an engineer that goes under the dirty stuff. When you see me wear my jacket in those days, somebody just look at me and say, this is your safari suit. He doesn't speak to you as an engineer now. I said, that's your problem. Your whole safari suit is your button this way. You know how the nurse is button one side? That is the kind of suit I wear to work. And the man looks at me and says, are you an engineer? I said, yes, I am. I didn't know that he didn't like me. But one day I got to know what happened. They were in the boardroom and they were holding a meeting, and the MD has determined that he was going to sack me. I didn't know. But he didn't know that I was the king's seed. I come from the royalty. I am of the royalty of heaven. I can't do anything against him. And suddenly they have discussed and they are finalizing there. One of the directors just said, excuse me, who is this man? Oh, say, you don't know him? He's our engineer. We need to get rid of him. You know what? They thought the man was going to support them. The man just said, excuse me, I have a vote in this board. And as long as you cannot tell me exactly what this man has done wrong, I raise up my hand to tell every one of you here, I disagree. You cannot sack him. And after so much arguments, they couldn't do it. Because the man he has a lot of weight in the place. They not asked me, was I in the board meeting? How did I get to know? I was just walking in the corridor one day, and the man just saw me. And I greeted the two directors who were in the corridor, and I greeted one of them, and because that one knows me very well, and they were just laughing. And I said, and I was just looking at them, they were laughing. And the man now, he called my name, and he went to call my name, oh. The man said, oh, you are the one that God has refused to allow this. I don't know the Yoruba, the English version. He said, any other Yoruba, I need to put that for you. The one God has never killed, okay, whatever you say. That was what the man said. Then I was curious and I asked questions, what's the problem? He said, Mr. Man, go and enjoy your life. He said, they have sacked you, but I didn't know you. I don't know what they have done for them, but I told them and they cannot sack you. That's how God fights with children. Be made a child of God and you will fight your cause. Brethren, did you hear? Remain a child of God. Remain God's seed. Remain the King of Kings' seed. He will fight your cause.
Amen.
You will not, the Bible says he walks in mysterious ways and his ways start finding out. Mm. And he does wonders without wonder. Mm. That is God. All you need to be sure of is to align with God. Whenever you align with God, get this understanding that I'm going to be giving you. Every works of darkness become a walkover for you. Because it is the nature of the king to trample upon the works of darkness. And as long as you are a king's seed, and of his lineage, whatever authority the king has been given to you. Whatever the capacity of the king, because you are his seed, belongs to you. But that's why the scripture says, let's open Ephesians. I want to show you a word of God there. Ephesians chapter number 1. Ephesians chapter 1. Because as a king's seed, you have authority to walk over that thing because your father does. And the firstborn does also. Who is the firstborn?
Jesus.
Jesus is the firstborn. And if the firstborn does, then you can. Ephesians chapter 1, look at verse 19. And what? Let's read it together. And what is the exceeding greatness of his power? Where? In us. Yes? Wait, let me stop there. As long as you believe and you cross that line of giving your life to Jesus Christ, you regain all the authority of the king's seat. Which he wrought with us, the power towards us. Let's go now. According to the working of his mighty power. What did he do? Go ahead, but this verse. Which he wrought in Christ. Yes? When he raised him up from the dead. And set him where? Far above all principalities and power, and might and dominion, and every name that is above that is named. Not only in this world, but also in the world. Let's read verse 22. And has put all things under his feet, and gave him to be the head of all things to the church. What can he get here? Look at the first verse I read to you. And what is it? Read that first verse, 19. Can you see? Let's read it together. Read it. Towards who? Towards who?
Me.
Who believe? What did he now say about that power? Which he did what? Well, stop there. The same power that he used to raise Jesus Christ from the dead, to make him number one seed in the entire family. He said the same power he wrought towards you. Whenever you do what? You got it. Every time you believe God, let me tell you, brethren, God will help me to communicate this to you. I'm not a good orator, but it's working for me. You know what happened? The Bible says there is a power that is working for you every time you believe God. I now say, let me showcase that power to you. The same power that I have given you every time you believe, I wrought it in Christ Jesus. And when I did in Christ Jesus, what did he do? He resurrected from the grave. Why? And it now put all the kingdom of darkness under him. And by his name, why do you think that the kingdom of darkness said, Jesus I know. What did he mention next? Even Paul. Because Paul now started working as a king's seat. You can't touch him anyhow. By virtue of that power that restored you back to where you belong, you cannot trample the kingdom of darkness under your feet, Mary. Enough of having terrible dreams where they press you down. He said, they press me down. Every now and then, they press you down. Some of you are still experiencing it, and you don't know what to do anymore. And yet, you are claiming to be king's seed. There's problems somewhere. You should be able to pray to the point that in your dream, when any forces of darkness want to come against you, you are still praying and attacking them in prayer. You have prayed so much and you have imbibed the power of the Holy Spirit into you that when you are sleeping, you are still blowing tongue. Because your brain is not asleep. To the point that the devil will say, this one, leave me. We can't do anything. That is the evidence of the king's seed. You must be able to trample them under feet. In fact, he said to you, he has allowed the same power in you in order to establish you as his own seed. Yes. And he demonstrated it in Christ Jesus. No wonder the scripture said to us in that Philippians chapter 2 that you always quote, because he has obeyed God and he humbled himself to the death of the cross, God has highly exalted him. That is why he said, you are seated with him, man. As a king's seed, no devil should be able to touch you. This is what you need to understand. Let me quickly warn you. Christianity is not so much about jumping up and down. It's so much about who you know and how you walk in that knowledge. So when you walk in that knowledge, it becomes difficult for the devil to play around your life. Brethren, you have the authority over the works of
darkness.
The capacity has been transferred to you the moment you gave your life to Jesus Christ.
Luke chapter 10, verse 19.
He said, "Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents. As a king's seed, you should be able to do it. Don't be a mediocre anymore in the spiritual battles of life. Stand strong against the kingdom of darkness. Because may I tell you the secret now? The devil has gone rampage and is going to be dealing with a lot of people in North America. Watch out. Are you hearing me? With the decision of June 26th, am I correct?
Yes.
In America. You watch. If you want to know how much terrible that decision is, go back and read your Genesis chapter number, is it chapter 18? When God said to Abraham, said, "I heard the cry of Sodom." There is a cry coming to me from Sodom and Gomorrah. Was it people that were praying? No! It was iniquity of gay, lesbianism that was crying to them. Say, "God, what can you do? We will do whatever you like here." And God said, "I have come down to see all together whether the cry of it is true." Is it because God doesn't? I'm not teaching you about that. But when such things come upon the face of the earth, and when episcopal bishops are affirming the same thing, people that carry color and they stand on the altar and they are affirming the same thing, know that apostasy is here. And in a lot of terrible things will need to happen. Only the king's seed will know how to stand.
Yes, sir.
Only those who know their God that shall be strong and will be doing exploits. They will know the power of God that is available to them. They will know the grace of how to walk upon the serpent and scorpion. And say, "Look, he has given us the power. We belong to the king. And all the authority of the king has been given to us. And as the king sees, we can ride upon them. We can walk upon them. It doesn't matter how the harassment of the kingdom of darkness may appear. Bible says you will cast out devils." Say, "Behold, I give you power over the enemy. And nothing shall by any means hurt you." It is not meant for all. If all the other kings see from all the small letter Egon nation in the land of Babylon decided to walk straight into that fire, they will be burnt. But they will come and say, "Did I not throw three people into that place? How come I see the fourth person?" If you want to see the fourth person appearing for you, brethren, remain as a king's seed. Because it is only when you remain as a king's seed of the lineage of the King of Kings that the resources of heaven will be released for you. It will be released. It is up. You see, look at yourself now. How many times have you gone out there to take care of the homeless? When it seems as if you don't have any money in your pocket. But let your child cry to this place now. In fact, you said there was no money before. When there was a homeless guy, even this your boy, before he cried very well, he said, "Okay, my son, keep quiet, keep quiet." Take everything you have in your pocket, you empty. Why? Because it's of your seed.